So moving on to the Aging with Empowerment program, this program started in 2017 and was really a product of the fact that we had had community engagement sites for quite some time, and we had some individuals really aging in place with us in those programs. And at some point they were starting to express to us that they enjoyed coming to program, they liked what they did there, but they weren't necessarily enjoying spending 6 hours a day with people in their early 20s. They were like, this is not my peer group. So we designed a program that was really geared towards them. So we focus on supporting older adults. How does that differ between our community engagement program? We give them flexible start and end times. So for some individuals aren't so great in the morning, they can come in a little bit later. Others like to start bright and early, but after lunch, they're kind of done. So we give them the opportunity to really kind of set what their daily schedule looks like. We have varied support ratios so that if some people can be fine in a group in the community, but really need one-on-one support while they're eating because of a medical need, we can do that. We provide opportunities to develop friendships, get out in their community. We absolutely focus on community access. Like I said, it may not be 5 hours a day. It's going to be whatever makes sense for the person and the people in their group. And also we spend a lot of time with informed memory care, mobility, and medical supports because those support needs become a little bit more intense as some individuals age. The idea is to keep people engaged as long as possible so that they can stay in their natural environment as long as possible, because we know that that really assists with positive aging outcomes. We have three Aging with Empowerment locations in the St. Louis area now. We have Crevecoeur, which was our original location, and that is located near the Dautel Circle area. One in Hazelwood, and then our newest one is in Maplewood, and that also opened in February of 2022. As you can see, I've got a few pictures here of what the sites look like. It's really important because all of our sites were designed with dementia-capable design. And there's a lot of components and research went into that. But what that is you can see you've got some really bold colors on the wall and some really solid colors on the floor so that it's easier for individuals experience some forms of dementia to navigate their own environment. And this really helps them increase their own independence. They don't have to depend on staff to help them get around because it's designed to be very clear and easy for them to navigate. And all of our Aging with Empowerments program sites are set up in the same way. You can see some dementia capable signage as well, just make it crystal clear. An example I like to give, if you see that restroom sign, most universal restroom signs are of a man and a woman, not a toilet. They're just of people, which doesn't always make sense when you're thinking about a restroom. So we just made it extra clear. If you need to find the toilet, here is a picture of the toilet outside of where that is. So just small things like that and those tweaks have really made it a little bit easier for individuals to navigate.